Marguerite Annie Johnson, life started out to be fairly typical for a little southern black girl in the 30s and 40s, a mixture of exciting times and extreme racism. At that time, the black experience ranged from Black Wall Street to a lynching. There was no norm. You just never knew. One day you could be on top of the world, and the next day somebody could come through and burn it all down. And in the midst of all that oppression, women were subclass to the subclass, making little black girls vulnerable and voiceless. And then one day, Vivian told Marguerite, Maya, she said, you know, baby, I think you're the greatest woman I've ever met. And right there, eyeball to eyeball, she removed earthly barriers as if to say it's now between you and God. Then Maya was inducted into the 60s, the time when the country was most awake. Everybody was coming together, meeting, collaborating to make change. Civil rights, women's rights, workers' rights, gay rights, a woman's right to choose, stop the war. Why are we even fighting at all? Equal education, freedom of speech, a right to vote, an equal right to exist. At that time, every artist, musician, and public figure had something to say. It was important to be on the right side of history when it happened. And now Maya had found her voice, and over the next 10 years, she would publish her first 5 books. I know why the caged bird sings, just give me a cool drink of water before I die, still I rise, gather together my name, singing and swinging and getting merry like Christmas. Maya would go on to speak, preach, project, protect, pontificate, elaborate, analyze, prioritize, synchronize, tell it on the campus, streets, and church, the truths we must know about one another. By this time, she was Dr. Maya Angelou, and her gifts had made room for her. With a body of work that consisted of 8 autobiographies, 18 books of poetry, 3 personal essays, 2 cookbooks, 6 plays, 15 separate works of film and television, acted in 11 plays and films, and 8 recordings. She kept step with the voice of God in her head. And on May 28th, the cage door opened, and the one that Galilean carpenter calls Maya flew home.